Now, originally I planned to just walk you through my journey. We've all got amazing journeys. We all have. Mine's been interesting. In fact, I actually wrote about it. But because of what I've been doing here this week, and the reason I'm here, I started off telling you about Asia. I've lost the plot already. I went to Hong Kong, because in Hong Kong, there is a conference that I go and speak at called Amplify Asia. And this is all the LGBT affirming churches in Asia. So mainland China, Hong Kong, Singapore, Taiwan, Malaysia, Philippines, Japan, Indonesia. It's an amazing conference, truly amazing. I just feel so honored to be in the presence of these people. And at this particular one, we had the one and only openly gay minister in mainland China. The only openly gay minister in mainland China. That's a quarter of the world's population. Some of these churches are the only LGBT affirming church in their countries. In some of these countries, being gay or lesbian carries it's a criminal offence, and they can go to jail for being who they are, not even practicing. So, you know, it's a very interesting thing to go and attend. I'm very, very honoured to be there. And then I'm here in Los Angeles. Well, I'm not Los Angeles, am I? It's Orange County, California. Where am I? Yeah, I'm in California, aren't I? That's right. So here I am. What am I doing here? The most incredible thing happened. How many of you have heard of Exodus? For those of you who haven't heard of Exodus, Exodus is an organization which has existed for nearly four decades. It was founded in 1976. In 1976, this organization was formed to help homosexual people who were Christians to become straight. It doesn't work. And if you've been watching the news this week, you will know that that organization, first of all, issued an apology to the LGBTQ community. For all the harm that's been done, for the lives that have been lost because of an evil message which said, you are not good enough. Homosexuality is a sin. It's a choice. And you can change it. Those three lies were perpetrated by this organization for nearly four decades. So the apology is groundbreaking. I began a dialogue with the director or president of Exodus in 2010. And what I did was, I don't like to attack people. Why don't I like to attack people? Because I don't like being attacked myself. And I caught lots of it this week. From Christians and from gay and lesbian people. I'll talk about that more later. So every time Alan Chambers did something good, I wrote to him. And I said, thank you, Alan. That's really good what you've just done. For example, the very first email I sent to him, Exodus had decided that it would not support the Day of Truth. In high schools, there was this program called the Day of Silence, where students refused to talk to remind people about how damaging bullying is for lesbian and gay and transgender and intersex youth. And the Christians decided that they would have a day on the same day, and they would call it the Day of Truth. So they were going to be silent, but they were going to tell the truth that homosexuality was a sin. And Exodus in 2010 said, no, we will not be a part of that program any longer. So I emailed Alan and said, Alan, that's going to make a huge difference to so many people. So this dialogue began to get warmer and warmer. And then in February, I just said to him, how would you feel about me attending the Exodus conference? What a stupid thing to say. Here is me, a leader of the LGBT community in Australia, twice voted one of the 25 most influential gay and lesbian Australians, a full-on gay man, gay Christian, all these things, saying, oh, how would you feel about me coming to your conference? And he emailed back and he said, I would love you to come. I am hungry for change. I am praying you must do what you feel God wants you to do. I already had a strong sense I was meant to be there, but I had no idea at that time what this would mean. Because at the opening night of the conference, on Wednesday night, Alan Chambers got up in front of the conference and said, it's over. Exodus is closing down. Amazing. Lots more work to do. Exodus is not gay affirming. Let me just get that correct. They are not gay affirming, but as their organization, their umbrella organization, is shutting down. So it's been an interesting week. Interesting week at that conference, talking with people, meeting with Alan, Randy Thomas, and others in the organization.